Welcome back, viewers. Today we will be testing the Kijun Sen distance indicator.
But before we do, if you have not watched my first video and the videos after that, you need to go do that right now. Here at the Academy of Forex, we are building the best trading system possible as a team, and as a team, we will all profit from it when we are done. You can find a link to the first video down in the description below. You can also find a link to our Discord server, so that way we can all discuss testing indicators and building our trading system. And lastly, you can find a link below to TradingView. If you sign up for a paid account, you will save a little bit of money using the link below.
Alright, as I said, today we will be testing the Kijun Sen distance indicator. But before we do, wanted to put the indicator scoreboard up for everyone to see. So, to date, we have tested 87 indicators. And out of those 87 indicators, 29 of them have been winners, which means that they have met or exceeded the 60% win-loss ratio threshold that we have set for them. The best ones so far were able to achieve a 100% win rate. Now you need to go back and watch those videos to understand the context of how they were able to achieve that. But as we are working on building the best trading system possible, you could take any one of those 29 indicators and get out there and start potentially profitably trading the markets with them now. So go back and watch those videos, make a list of those indicators, and get out there and see what you can do with them. But stick with us here as we work on maximizing your trading profits. All right. So, as I said, today's indicator is the Kijun Sen distance indicator. And it is a TradingView member created indicator. So, of course, there will be a link to the indicator below in the description. So, the Kijun Sen, it is a piece from the Ichimoku cloud system. Well, I guess it could be called the, it's technically the Ichimoku indicator. It also has a specific part to it that is the Ichimoku cloud. Yeah, the Ichimoku. Some of you may have noticed that I've never tested the Ichimoku. It's not that I haven't played around with the Ichimoku myself. It's that it is one crazy beast of an indicator. And there are just so many different ways to go about trading it, that I find it difficult, challenging to really narrow in on one specific way to trade it. So it may be one that I tackle at some point, but often what we find in playing around with indicators is that there are typically some good aspects to some indicators, and so a lot of indicators have you know, quite a few different moving parts to them. It's not just a line. Like a moving average is just a line. That's it. You can add things to it to, you know, interact with it, or you know, do with it whatever you will, but when it boils down to it, it's just a line. That's it, right? There are a lot of indicators out there that are more than just a line. There's multiple lines, there's zones, there's levels, there's, you know, just tons of different aspects to it. And so what we find sometimes is that you can kind of discover small single aspects to an indicator that has multiple different pieces to it. And that one piece, that one aspect, does a really good job as an indicator kind of by itself. And so sometimes when you have indicators, especially one that is large and has as many moving parts as the Ichimoku, and if you don't know what the Ichimoku is, look it up. You'll be quite astonished. I was whenever I first learned about it. I was like, man, there is just so much to this indicator. It's, you know, can it was developed to be an all-in-one indicator. And so, by its nature, it's going to have a bunch of moving parts to it. And so, when you have indicators like the Ichimoku, you can sometimes pick out specific pieces of it and use those specific pieces, and they work really well. But as a part of the whole big indicator, you know, in itself, it, you know, sometimes those pieces don't work very well as a system. And so I've seen before where people have pulled out, and I've done it myself. I've you know, went into the Ichimoku and, you know, turned off visibility to specific parts of it and played around with it, you know, dozens of different ways before I started this channel. And so it's interesting to see that some other people have pulled out specific parts of it and created pretty much a standalone indicator with that part. And so this is one of those instances where they have taken the Kijun Sen from the Ichimoku and created a standalone indicator around it. And so that is, you know, kind of where this indicator came from. And so with all that being said, there's not, I mean, I'm sure there is more to it than, I'm sure there's more to it than how I am going to test it. Often, like a lot of you know, there is, you know, a really defined way by the creator, or sometimes no defined way at all. Sometimes they're just like, here's an indicator, take it, do with it what you will. And then sometimes they give you, you know, kind of instructions, but those instructions are kind of like, that doesn't make much sense. And so this is one of those aspects where, you know, I pulled it up and, you know, kind of played around with it a little bit, looked at it, and decided, you know, hey, I think I'm going to test it this specific way. And actually going back and looking now at the creator's page on where they listed this, this particular indicator, they really didn't give a lot of information on how to trade it. And so we kind of got to use our best judgment as to what the best way is to attempt to trade it. And so I believe what I am going to do is very similar to the last indicator that we tested, the range identifier. So this is how the indicator looks when you first bring it up on your screen. And what I've done is I have went in and on the Kijun Sen background, I'm going to bump these up to 50. There. And come on. No, I just enter it in on my keypad, but there we go. All right. I've made the background a little bit more visible. And so I believe the way we're going to do this is very similar to, like I said, the way we did the range identifier, I think is what it was, on the last video. And that is when the background turns green, that's going to be a signal to go long. When the background turns red, that's going to be a signal to go short. Pretty simple setup. That's how we're going to test it now. It is interesting to note that the creator of this indicator has a few other indicators that seem to be based around the Ichimoku system, where they have pulled out specific pieces of it and created a standalone indicator around it. And so I have those on the list also that I'll tinker around with, and I will most likely do some videos on those also. All right, first signal there, it was a short signal, and unfortunately it turned around, took off on us, stopping us out for our first loss, and then it took off the opposite direction, giving us a signal to go long, giving us a really solid trade. And so we're going to play it out here. You can see here that it is, I'm not really sure what these, I'm not sure if there's a histogram buried behind this. I didn't see one, but you can see these, like these little meter lines here that seem to be following something ahead of price action here. Thought was interesting. All right, our next signal there. That was a short, and we got a win on that one. Not too bad. It's not giving a lot of signals, and so that's, you know, that's not wonderful, but it's not the end of the world either. It's just a matter of how good those signals are. And so yeah, that's about the 1 year or the half year marker right there. We'll just keep plugging along here, see what else we can get out of this. But yeah, it'd be nice if it, you know, would have picked up like the trend change right here. I mean, it wasn't a huge uptrend, but it was definitely an uptrend. And then boom, it shot back down for a downtrend here, which it technically is still reading that original downtrend and not really giving us much there. All right, popped up right here with another signal long, which unfortunately turned around and dropped us out. Then we got this short right here, which turned right around to give us a long there, stopping us out before going short again there. And boom, getting a win on that one. All right, there is a long signal there. That one definitely got us to take profits. And then it's starting to get all kinds of jumpity here. So it went down, giving us a short signal, then popped back up for a long signal before dropping back down for, oops, let's get that again, dropping down for a moment for a short before then calling a long, which does not appear as though it did not hit profit either. And then that short there, let's see, where are we? Okay, yeah, we're still good, we're still within the year. So it dropped out there. That probably gave us a win there. Then popped up here. I bet it gave us a win on that one. Drop down here. Let's play it out a little bit and see what it does. That was probably, let's see, there, here to here. And that is, what is that, 140? Nope. So that would not, that one was not a winner. All right, then it, oh, come on. Stop fighting the lines there. Then it, boom, 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 started jumping up right there, but we haven't got far enough to see where that's gonna go. It went up good ways there. Definitely giving us, there we go. And that is the end of the year there. All right, so it went from giving us almost no signals in a really good trending market to giving us a whole bunch of signals in a really choppy market. And so you can see how that could be very problematic. And so let's count them out here. We got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. And we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. 7 winning trades. And so unfortunately, that is not going to meet the 60% criteria. You know, I think what I might do is actually give this one another chance, but in a different way. I think what I'm going to do is go in, return these to the default settings. I think I am going to give you a little preview of what we'll be attempting on the next video. So I think what we're going to do is use this as a zero line. You can see here that the Kijun Sen line here, and it has a zero set on it. And so I think we might see what it can do as a zero line cross. I might actually just turn off the background there. Try to get a little bit more. I don't know why. Is it just not vibrant? There we go. Those really vibrant greens and reds there. Yeah, I think what we might do is test it as a zero line cross and see what we can do. I mean, some of these moves, these trend moves that we see here, definitely would have been caught by a zero line cross. And so yeah, at the moment we're gonna say no to this. We're gonna put it on the no list as far as you know, how we tested it this way. We'll try it on a zero line cross in the next video, see what we can get out of it and see if that will meet the 60%. But at the moment, it is a no.
If you have not already, like this video, comment below, subscribe to the channel, and turn on the bell notification so that way you are notified anytime I post a new video. As part of the team, it's important that you are seeing the new videos as they come out so you know what it is that we are discussing and what indicators we are testing, have tested, and have not tested. Also, like usual, there is a link below in the description to the Discord server. You can join us on Discord so that way we can further discuss the indicators and have discussions as we move forward building our trading system. And lastly, like usual, there is a link below to TradingView. If you like what you see whenever I use TradingView and you are interested in signing up for TradingView, if you use the link below, and sign up for a paid account, you will save a little bit of money. So, all right, everybody, I will see you on the next.